we'd like to present the results of ongoing projects which are based on specific archaeometric analysis and was conducted by several of researchers with different kinds of science. So you can see these people on this first picture. And this research was conducted on pottery from cemetery in Vicina. As you know, the urn files are very well known from the enormous amount of pottery, and we know that. And you can read the assumption which were made for two sites, so Vicina and Domasław, so a really huge amount of pottery. From Poland, from the southwestern part of Poland, we know something about 300 locations of urn period. So the vast majority of these are cemeteries. So this is a small conclusion that the pottery is the main source of knowledge for this period. And traditionally, in traditional way, pottery are developed, are elaborated in a very traditional way. So they are used to determine the chronology and the culture. As you can see on this picture, the table of chronology and typology was made for the Białowice group. It was noticed funerary pottery involves similar repeatable set of vessels, which thanks to the shape suggest with liquids, suggest contact with liquids. That's why the idea was born. Funeral pottery made only for funeral rite and no use on settlement. Additionally, set of typical domestic pottery as conical necked vessels and pots, but in miniaturized version, were also placed in the graves. Another factor confirming this assumption was grave good arrangement that indicates ritual actions connected to ritualized drinking, symposium, libation. So as we can see in this in the inner group, and the manifestation of domestic space, as we can see in this outer group. These features observed in this at the cemetery in Białowice group were also observed in Vicina cemetery, which is elaborated by our research team. The conception of symposial drinking set and feasting customs were taken from the Mediterranean world. In connection with the situation of access to materials from the settlement and from the nearby cemetery in Vicina, there was an opportunity to take a different look at ceramics. We posted a few questions about the pottery. First of all, are vessels produced and used in the settlement are reused as funeral ones? The second one, are vessels were made specially for burials? And the third, what was the pathway from the settlement to cemetery, how it looks like, how it could look? So pottery derived from the famous settlement Vicina, which was discussed today. But I would like to mention that these materials were published only from the excavation conducted in the period 2008 and 2011. And the funerary materials derived from the nearby cemetery have never been elaborated until the project in 2016 were started. And now we will focus on these pottery assemblages. So the Vicina, this fortified settlement, the frequency forms of ceramic items on the settlement show the most frequent occurrence of pots, amphoras and bowls. So you can see those forms. Comparing to the cremation cemetery, in graves most frequently were bowls, miniature vessels and then vases. So we can assume that the ceramic forms are very similar from stylistically a point of view, but the differences are the frequency of particular forms. The next step was to choose samples, pottery samples, to archaeometric analysis. So as you can see on these pictures, on this picture, the samples were very similar both to the cemetery and to the settlement. The samples from the cemetery was derived from the three phases of functioning this the cemetery, but the most frequently was the samples from graves dated to the Hallstatt Sea period. And the results from petrographic analysis, thin sections analysis from settlement, established beside the types, the amount and size of inclusions, but they also indicate some ways of surface treatment. Namely, the added slip layers were recognized on the surface, both so-called kitchen and table pottery. And I hope that you see in these thin sections pictures the these added layers. Chemical analysis indicates two different sources of raw materials which would be located in the closest neighboring to the settlement. So now the analysis which were conducted in our project, cemetery. So petrographic results show the most common inclusions. That's where mineral grains, also organic material and grog were also used, but particularly in the pottery dated to the Hallstatt D. The latter inclusions did not occur in the settlement samples. So both petrographic analyses from settlement and cemetery show that a prehistoric pottery workshop was characterized by the lack of the required combination of recipes. Another set of analyses, namely, so using the scanning microscope, electron microscopy, allows to observe the process of surface treatment. A common characteristics were very careful surface treatment, sometimes leading to the surface polishing. In the scanning image of many samples, one can observe parallel grooving typical for ceramic surface, smoothed with a hard tool with a smooth surface, such for example as a pebble. On this picture 3, you can see rarely protruding sharp edged rock fragments. The next picture, this four picture, show outer surface of the same sample where the cavitas formed as a result of smoothing residual organic matter is visible as traces of blackening process during fining. We can see increased carbon content, the presence of diagnostic peaks of sulfur and nitrogen in the small picture here below, so in the EDS spectra. At the edge of the thin sections are seen thick layers characterized by small amount of grains and orderly arrangement of clay minerals. So this picture shows it very clearly. The layers distinguished by the green color in the last three pictures. So this is compared to this inner mass ceramic masses, basis ceramic mass. The same surface finishing were established at the settlement samples. So we have these very similar features. On the outer surface of the one vessel, it can be observed the characteristic of two-step application of the slip. So at the cemetery, we have two layers of slip. The confirmation of the hypothesis about the possibility of using local raw materials will be test of ceramic samples and raw material using the thermal and X-ray diffraction analysis. So this is in progress, and we don't have the really all the results of this test. But physical features aimed to determine the degree of water absorption, total porosity, and waterness. So the features determining the potentials suitably of ceramics for storing liquid substances and the technological level of pottery. Four groups were distinguished with degree of range of values. First groups were the lowest porosity and water absorption. So the pottery are the best containers. So it indicates that pottery could be the best containers for the storage of liquids. The group third and four, so these groups, have the worst physical parameters, so the fluid permeability is very high. We could observe no big vessels and amphoras and drinking set in the third and fourth group. Miniature vessels and special forms occur in the third and fourth group. The most domestic vessels, according to the results of this analysis, could be big vases, big amphoras, bowls, pots, and almost this assemblage of pottery is the most typical pottery of Białowice group. Ceramics have been also examined for potential of organic residue by using chromatography analysis. By examining the components that have been absorbed into pottery, it is possible to explore pottery function in the past. This examination reveals remains of cereals, vegetable materials, pine pitch and resin, paraffin wax and bitumen. Comparing these results to physical characteristics and these four groups, this is the groups of physical characteristics, reveal that cereals will exist in each of these four groups. The most interesting are samples which pine pitch and resin, paraffin wax and bitumen. These materials indicate to sealing the surface of pottery. Comparing the physical features, samples of drinking sets, so bowls and cups, but also pots and vases were placed in the two first groups. So represent the best conditions to domestic activity. Sensor, so this item. The item compared to model of the oven have also remains of pine resin, what could in the case indicate some type of the combust or of fragment substances. At the last interesting samples is represented by this large conical necked vessel, where both pine pitch and vegetable material were established. It should be added that this vessel was an urn engraved. So we could suppose that first these vessels were used as container to storage plant material and then reused as a graves good. So to conclude and sum up this multidisciplinary research, we could say that some of vessels could be reused as funerary pottery. The most large vases and amphoras. Some of pottery, like these very small vessels, miniature vessels, and as pointed juglets and pots, which seems to have replaced large storage and cooking vessels, were produced only for symbolic use, for one use, like for the funerary rites. In functional interpreting the pottery, we should not be suggested only by their shape. The same forms of vessels could be used in different ways. And we have hope that these positive results of our investigations could bring comparing analysis of physical parameters of pottery and traces or organic materials, And this direction, this way of conducting research could shed a new light to the enormous amount of pottery which is found at the Urfahrt period. So thank you very much.